Hey everyone, we're back. I'm Mac here, and today we're going to teach you how to sew a pillow. Now you can use this tutorial to make any size pillow you want. Just remember, the bigger the pillow you make, the longer it will take. But for today, for video purposes, I will be using this little piece of fabric to make a little pillow so that I can make it and make the video all in one day. So you'll need a piece of fabric. I'm using a little one. You can use a big one to make a full-size pillow for like yourself, but I'm just making this little one. I don't know what I'll do with it, but it's just so that I can make my video all in one day. You'll need a needle. Pins are optional, but I do recommend them. You'll need thread. You'll need scissors. I have my pink ones. And you'll need stuffing of some sort. This is just whatever I happen to have. You could even stuff it with like scraps of fabric or... Back when I first started sewing, I actually stuffed things with like plastic bags like from Walmart. But that makes them not stuffy. So you're making like a pillow and you want to sleep on it, don't use plastic bags. If you're doing just a little thing to practice, it doesn't matter. But big pillow to sleep on, don't do plastic bags. See, you just use stuffing. So first, you're going to need to take your fabric. And if you want to make something, if you have a piece of fabric and you want to make a smaller thing, you're going to want to lay it out and measure it and cut it and stuff, but I'm just going to use this whole little piece because it's not real big. And whenever you get your size or your shape or whatever, you're going to want to take it and fold it in half. And you're going to need to take pins. Here, I'm going to tip the camera down so you can see better. Here. Hello! So you'll need your fabric right here. You'll take a pin. You're going to line up the corners. See the corners? You got to line them up. This is important to the shape of your pillow. And you stick your pin in, and then stick it back through like this. And that's how you pin. And then you gotta do that as many as you want. You only have to do a couple if you're a little more comfortable with sewing, but if you're a beginner, you're gonna want to use more. See. I'm gonna put in, I think just two on each side, and then one or two in the middle. The bigger the project, the more pins will be, helpful. For a little thing like this, I don't really care if it's perfect, so I'm only going to put a couple pins in. So see, I have two on each side. Now I think I'll do two in the top part up here. There's many different ways like you can put in pins, depending on how you like to do it. This is how I do it, because it takes less pins. You could do it this way along the edge, but that takes more pins, and I don't want to use that many pins. So there, now that you've pinned it, see, it won't come apart. It's like, see? It's like pinned. Now you need your thread. You have to unwind a bunch. Remember, unwind more than you need, because it's easier to cut off the extra than it is to add on more. So I'm unwinding a whole bunch of thread. And remember, unwind, if you think you have too much, unwind more. Because the way I do it, and the way I'm teaching you to do it, I will use my bigger-eyed needle. Because it'll be easier to show you how to thread the needle. So you find the end of your thread. Easier said than done. Where is the end? Find the end of your thread. You take the end. This is the hard part to show you. See the eye of my needle? Stick the thread right through it. So that your needle is now on there. And the way I do it, because otherwise, if you do, you could just tie it, just do it like this. But the way I do it, because otherwise my needle always slides off the thread, the way I do it is I find the other end of my thread, and I match them up, and then I just knot it together so it's one big loop. It's also double threaded, so it will be much stronger. If you're making a pillow like for yourself to sleep on, I do recommend double threading it. See? And my needle's attached to it. So then, you just pick a place. See how this edge is already attached together because the fabric is folded? I recommend starting in either this corner or this corner. Because then you only have to go around one, down, and then you don't have to, like... If you came this way, if you started here, you have to go down, and then you have to start over here again. But if you just start here, you can go all the way around. It's a lot easier. So start in the corner by where your fold is. Just stick your needle right through. And pull it through. Make sure not to pull it all the way through so your thread comes out. Now stick it right next to where your thread went through before. Stick it right back through. Now, here's the part where it's going to make it your life easier. You take your thread. You see where your little knot is? Right through my finger? Stick, it makes a loop. Stick your needle through that loop and pull it. This will hold your stitch in. See, now look at, now I tug on it and it's attached. It can't like slide back through on me. So now just go. If you've seen my other sewing video, just how to sew the sewing basics. If you see my sewing basics video, it'll be much easier for you. And you just go in and out. I'm just doing a plain stitch in and out stitch. You could do a back stitch or any other stitch you want, but I find just there's no reason to really. You can just do an in and out stitch. You just stitch like this. You just go back and forth. Just so that the thread, but don't like do too far apart and don't do too close together. Somehow I got a knot in my thread. Which is why I stopped the camera for a second. If you get a knot like this, you can't untie, and you just can't get it through your fabric. Because you think if you ripped it, it would break your thread or rip your fabric. I recommend you just take your thread that's on the other side that doesn't have the knot, and take this piece that has the knot that won't go through, and just take them and knot them together so that you can cut off the part with the knot and just keep going. You just take them and you just tie them together. And then you just take the part where the knot was, not the part with your needle, the part where the knot was, and just cut off that extra. And then just throw it away. Or save if you have a thing you do with extra thread. And then just continue sewing. Go in. And out. In. And out. Now, if you don't understand what I'm doing, go watch my basic sewing video first. Then come back and do this. It'll make your life a whole lot easier. Now, when you've gotten to a point where you're sewn and you're past where your needle is, you can just pull that needle out and put it away. Because it's just going to poke you and it's not really doing anything anymore. You keep going in and out. In and out and in and out and tug on. Now, if you're going to pause the video and just do this without me and like watch something else, because this is kind of boring, I know. I do that all the time. Then remember, come back before you finish sewing. If you're going to like leave and come back and then fast forward this part or something, don't go farther than like here. This is where the fold is. This is where you're sewing around. Stop about halfway through your last one. Unless it's a big project, then you can go a little closer. Just keep sewing and sewing and sewing. In and out and in and out and in and out and in and out. Now I got to a point where I can take another pin out. So now this end is just sewn. Now I can keep going. And when you turn a corner, you don't really like do anything special. You just start stitching this direction instead of this direction. If you had a sewing machine, this would go a whole lot faster. But if you know how to use a sewing machine, you don't really need to be watching an easy video like this. In. Out. Now, if you don't pull it too tight, see this kind of stitch? If you pull it too tight, it'll all bunch up. So you gotta be careful. If it does that, you just pull it back open. This is why you gotta be careful not to pull too tight. It'll bunch it up. That's why if you did a back stitch, it couldn't do that really. And out. Now I can take another needle out. Or pin. Not needle. Pin. Only use one needle. You could use, if you had extra needles and you didn't have any pins, you could use your needles as pins, but they would come out easier. It means they wouldn't stay in and hold things in as good. In. And out. In. And out. In. And out. Now I think I got another pin. Remember, if it bunches up, just pull it back out loose again. Nothing to get worried about. They didn't wreck anything. In and out. Now I'm right to the corner. I can turn again. Out. And in. And if you're sewing and your pin, what you want to sew is you where your pin is just getting in the way, just take your pin out and hold the fabric with your fingers. It's a lot easier because your pin will get in your way at times. Keep going in and out until you're about, if you're making a little one like me, go about halfway. If you're making a big one, leave about 2.5 to 3 inches. If you're making a big one, leave like 4, or a really big pillow, leave like 4 or 5 inches. The more you leave, the better it will be. For the little one like this, you can leave like 2 inches, something like that. And also, the farther away from the edge you sew, the better your thing will end up being, because it will have more seam, and it will be less likely to rip and stuff. So don't get too close to the edge of your fabric. I'm going to go out one more time, and then I'm going to stop sewing for a little bit, and we're going to stuff our little pillow. Now, you can do this two ways, I've found. First of all, take your pin out, because you don't need your pin anymore. You can do this two ways. You can tie and cut off your thread right here, which will make things slightly easier, but then you'll have to retie your thread on all stuff, which will use up more thread, and then it will if you do it the other way. If you do it the other way, you just leave this thread attached, and you take your little thing, so there's this little opening, and you push everything up through that and turn it inside out. If you need a little help, be gentle, but you can use like the end of your scissors, or you can use the end of like a pencil or a paintbrush, or they actually have little stuffing sticks. I just don't know where mine is right now. It's somewhere else. You want to get the corners out nice so it has its shape. Now, the other way you could have tied the thread off, then done that, but I didn't do that. Now that you've turned it inside out, take some of your stuffing. Make sure you don't have to overstuff it. Take a little bit at a time and stuff it in that opening. Stuff it until it's this desired hardness or softness that you like. It's up to you. There's no right or wrong way to stuff a pillow or how much to put in it. I'm just doing a little bit. See if I need any more after this. I need any more? Yeah, I need a little more. You keep ripping off little chunks. You can always add more. It's harder to take it back out again, though. Stuff them down in this corner. You gotta make sure you get it evenly. So this corner's all smushy. I've got to stick my finger in there. If you had a big pillow, you wouldn't be able to reach your finger in there, really. You'd have to, like, get, like, a stick or something. And see, this corner's kind of smushy, too. So you got to stick it up in there so that you have a nicely shaped pillow. And now, see, as I pushed it up to these corners, this corner's empty and this corner's empty. So I have to put a little more in there. I still need a little bit more stuffing to put in this little area right here where the opening is. That still needs a little more stuffing. So one little tiny bit more piece of stuffing. Then I think it's going to be good. And take your time in stuffing it and make sure that it's the way you want it, not like overstuffed. So this is what I think is good for mine. So now if you tied your thread off, it shouldn't have gotten loose here. But if you didn't, you're going to want to pull on that to tighten it. Now here comes the little tricky part. You want enough stuffing here that when it's mushed, when it's all fluffed up, that your stuffing's here. But for this part, shove it down in there and try to get it to be down in there. Because now you're going to take this and fold the edges in a little bit so that they become... Because you see how like it's going to fray there? So take it and like fold it in like this. And then push it together like that. And if you want, you can even take a pin and pin it. You want to get them lined up so they're straight, or your pillow will end up being so wonky. See there? You pinned it like that. Now take your needle. We're going to do what I think is called a ladder stitch. That's what I've been told it's called, but I'm not positive. Take it, and you go, can't even see what I'm doing. You go like this. You go in, back out the same piece of fabric, like this. And then you go, and you repeat on the other side of the pillow. And you pull it through. Because this will kind of also hide your stitches, because it will be going in between the fabrics. And then you go back on the other side. And you pull it through. And you just keep doing this. If you need more detail on the stitch like this, go look up videos on how to do a ladder stitch. Or comment down below if you want a video. Let me do a video just on the ladder stitch. Because if you want that, I'll do it. But I'm not sure if anyone wants it. Because probably other people have done it. Ow. Yeah, be careful of your pins because they are sharp. And they will hurt when they poke you. It's not fun when you get poked. You just keep going. And keep going until you're done. At this point, my pin is being more annoying than it is helpful, so I'm going to pull it out. Just keep going back and forth and back and forth. Mine has a funny little knotted thing there that you probably want to try to get at to go inside, but since I'm going to not really care about that a whole lot because I'm not really not sure what I'm even going to do with this tiny little pillow. But I'd just stick it somewhere and never look at it again, probably. You just keep doing your ladder stitch until you get to the corner of your pillow. You could just stitch this normal, but then it wouldn't look as nice. If you do this little folded stitch thing, it'll end up looking 10 times nicer than if you just closed it and stitched it. I'm kind of going fast at this because I just don't really care about it. Because it's just a little sample pillow to show you guys. But if you're doing this like for yourself and wanted this to look nice, I recommend you take your time and go slowly. So there, now I'm to the corner. Now you can just smush your stuffing back into that corner because you pushed it all out earlier. You can smush it back in. See, there's your little pillow. Now you still have this needle thing. So now you're going to go, and I'm sticking through here. I'm going to go back through again. But I'm going to not pull it all the way through. So I have this and this. And I'm going to knot them together. Like three times. One. Two. One more time. Three. Now, you can cut this off, but then you have this weird little knot on the corner of your pillow. If you don't care, go ahead, but make it look nicer, you stick your needle right into your pillow, right next to where the knot is. It's harder than it looks. It's easier than it looks. The reason my pillow is being pesky and it won't let me stick it in. You stick it in right next to the knot. Stick it right in next to the knot. And it may come up some other place in the pillow, like down here in the middle somewhere. Doesn't really matter where. And just pull it through. If you can get it to come through, which mine doesn't want to go through. You just pull it through the center of your pillow like this somewhere. It doesn't really matter. Then pull it tight. And you pull it tight. And you cut it off. Because then when you pull your corner back out, it's your end is just hidden inside your pillow somewhere. And then you can repeat the same thing with your other piece of thread. You just stick it through your needle. Stick it in your pillow right next to the knot somewhere. Stick it out through the like, part of your pillow. Pull it through. But if you had a littler-eyed needle, it'd be much easier. This one your needle will come right off of because it's not tied to it. Pull that tight and cut your thread. Make sure not to cut your pillow, though. And then pull your corner back out, and there! You've sewn a pillow. If you like sewing videos, give this a thumbs up. Comment down below. What else do you want me to teach you how to sew? I know a lot how to sew lots of things, or I can learn how if you want me to teach you. And subscribe, because it helps me, because I only have 3 subscribers so far.